How do you feel about sustainable food as a whole? Do you have any?
Thank you for bringing it up. I remember. Yeah.
So,
I would love to be able to eat test tube meat. I think that's going to be the future. That's going to be the thing that solves this whole moral dilemma for everybody. If you just grow meat in a vat,
yeah,
and just eat that. Yeah. Someone who's a vegetarian now told me that after you stop eating like meat for a while, you stop craving it.
Yeah, yeah,
and that goes with any food actually, right? If you stop eating it, you kind of stop craving it because
It can take a while though.
It can take a while. Like one thing about processed sugar is, I can't believe I'm saying all this crap.
I can't do it. I can't get off it.
Yeah.
I can't sleep without like a Mars bar before I go to bed. It's the most unhealthy thing.
Yeah, it is very unhealthy. Processed sugar actually fires the same neurons as crack cocaine.
Oh man.
Yeah, so
it's way cheaper though.
Right. Way cheaper than crack cocaine and easier to snort. I'm not saying it does as much damage. I'm just saying that the addiction part of it
is definitely
the same. Yeah, so you start craving it and stuff.
Because I've tried to not
eat processed sugar,
and I can't.
Yeah,
but I can't.
But once you get off processed sugar, you'll actually experience major changes in your life. You'll start to feel a lot healthier. You start to have more energy. Actually, with less sugar, and I'm talking here like some kind of health food nut.
Yeah, it's really great because we're making pizza as well.
I'm not listening. I don't personally listen to any of the advice I just said. Yeah, I think some people are worried. I spoke to some vegans.
You're really mushrooming that too.
Oh, okay, is that?
No, but
then making me self-conscious with the mushroom.
I don't want to. I don't take them off. They're already ruined.
All right, I'll put like that much. Am I supposed to cut these, do you think? I remember they weren't cut, but...
If they weren't cut, let's recreate.
Okay.
Let's do it authentically.
Yeah, people with test tube meat, people go like...
What meat do they make first in the vats?
Right, so I think 2 months ago or 3 months ago, the first test tube meat burger was cooked and eaten. Like someone made meat, grew meat, and then made a burger and ate it, like as a press conference. And I told some vegan friends of mine who are very... you know, vehemently vegan because of the animal rights. That's the main reason. And so I said, would you consider eating test tube meat? And they made a good point. They said that it depends on whether or not animal products were used to make the test tube meat.
Yeah.
Which I was like, that blew my mind. Like, oh yeah, you're right. You could actually be killing more animals to make this test tube meat than you're saving, which would be diminishing returns. But assuming it was made without killing any animals, which is the whole point of test tube meat.
Yeah, that's the whole point.
Then would they eat it? And they said, oh, it depends. They can't bring themselves around to eating this pulsing mass of meat.
That's probably not the first step. You probably start with spaghetti sauce before you gave them like a still beating test tube heart.
Yeah, test tube heart. You know what? Maybe iPhones are causing Parkinson's. Like, you never know.
Yeah, maybe. But there's also a lot of...
I just blamed Apple. You better cut that. That's not.
We can cut whatever you like.
Yeah,
out of
you
it, so
probably should
worry.
Cut that one out. Probably should cut accusing Apple of. I didn't even say mobile phones. I said iPhones.
Yeah.
Every other phone's fine. Just iPhones cause Parkinson.
Definitely do.
So, because you're not a vegetarian either, are you?
No.
Right. That's my point. That's what I'm saying.
I'm not a vegetarian. I don't really eat a lot of mammal creatures. I kind of feel. Like, I will. I'm not vegetarian, and so if I go to someone's house and they're like, I made beef casserole for you, I would never say, oh, no, I don't eat that.
Right.
But I don't cook meat, I don't buy it, I don't...
We are in a similar phase of life then, because
they're just as dead.
I go out, yeah, once again, the same level of what do you call that, necrosis?
How old are you?
The taste buds? I'm 28.
I'm 25, yeah.
Okay, so close. Not as close as I thought, but still pretty close. I thought I was younger. I'm the same thing. I will go to someone. I will never cook meat at home anymore. I only cook fish and vegetables.
Yeah.
But when I go out to nice restaurants, I'll order meat. I have no qualms about you know that
just
stuff.
Just letting someone else deal with it.
Just outsourcing the murder.
What did you study?
Law. I did a law degree and a commerce degree.
Oh, yeah.
University of Melbourne. Represent.
Did they make you do like those team building?
That probably messed up the
team building exercises in the first few days. I did one, and they made us like make clothes out of newspaper and like.
What was this orientation for?
It was for uni, so it was for, all first years across all different degrees.
Right. But what did you study?
UWA.
No, but what did you study?
I studied English.
English, yeah. No, we didn't have hazing or anything like that.
No, it wasn't even hazing. It was like, come on, you are going to be so good friends. You just have to make clothes out of newspaper and then you'll all be together forever.
Yeah, see, I would rather be hazed.
I actually left it. My mum was like, okay, you've got no friends. She was pretty brutal about that. She's like, okay, you need to meet people. You need to get out there. Right. You need to make friends. And she enrolled me on this like 2-day overnight stay in the colleges kind of intensive friend making thing. And what I did was I left it. I would wake up in the tiny little dorm bed and everyone would be down there making clothes out of newspaper and whatever it was. Yeah. And I would cross over the road and sit by the river and wait. And then I would go back in. I couldn't deal with
that. Have you ever told this story before?
No, I haven't.
There you go. First someone told it. I thought so. I thought you would never. That sounds like a thing which you would never tell someone about.
I think I sat in a tree or something because I was like, oh, I can't go home because my mum will know. Like if I go home, like I can't stay here making clothes out of newspaper. So I just went to the library.
Did you ever regret that decision? No.
No. Yeah. No.
Perfectly functional, happy university life.
No, but it was at night when I couldn't sit in the dark across the road. I nearly died a couple of weeks ago. I have so many, and it's fine because I have also. I'm kind of been like, okay, that's gonna be fine. But I was walking to work, and I was like, no, I'm walking to work. I don't want to go to work. I was so grumpy about walking to work early in the morning. And a tram went through a green pedestrian crossing, and it was turning. So I was looking straight ahead, and the man went green, and I went to cross, and then like the tram was there, and I and I jumped back, and it was so close that the tram driver actually stopped and got out to make sure that he hadn't killed me.
Yeah, right.
And it was kind of like, oh no, I'm fine, and I don't feel any adrenaline anymore because of stand up. I think I don't. No, it's ruined me.
I'm like dead on the inside.
I can't feel. Well, not for. I don't feel, which I think is good because if you felt adrenaline every time that you got on stage, like huge amounts of it or something, then.
But there's still room for.
I still get nervous at some things. Like it's just if a tram comes and I'm cool, I'm pretty cool about it. But it was this nice moment of being like, I'm going to work. I'm going to work. Yes.
I'm still alive.
It's going to be a great day. Just that instant perspective.
Work is way better than death. I'm happy to work.